today I'm here with a new video, and this is kinda a part of my Shop My Stash, but it's not the Shop My Stash. As you may know, I have been doing Shop My Stash videos for my base products this whole year, and now in June I am planning to do not a Shop My Stash, but to use things in my collection that I want to use. So no typical products that I want to use. So now for this month in my Shop My Stash area, I would like to talk a little bit about blushes and highlighters that I have in my collection that I really love and that I would be sad if I would miss them. And I'm only going to talk about things that are available. I have some highlighter favorites that I really love that is a limited edition, so I'm not going to talk about them because I see no point of recommending them. But I first want to talk about a contour shade, and if you have been on my channel, I think you know which shade I'm going to talk about, and I think you are so sick and tired of this. It is, of course, the Sculpt from NYX. This is what I use for contour all the time, always. I love this. I think this is available as a single. I'm not 100% sure, but I think it is. I bought it in the big palette, but I think you can buy all the shades from the palette as singles. So this I really, really love. I just wanted to mention that. This is the best contour shade I have ever tried. So if we go into blushes, and this is not going to be a swatch video, I think. I'm going to start with two single blushes. That is from Nabla, and I've talked about these so much as well. I had these in Shop My Stash in January, my first Shop My Stash, I think. But these are the only two blushes from Nabla that I have, and I love these blushes. These are two of my absolute favorite blushes ever. So this is Kendra. Maybe you want to see a close up. So this is Kendra. It's a little bit darker and coal toned blush. And this is Nectarine, that is a little bit warmer and lighter. And I just love Nabla's blushes. I would recommend them if you want a blush that is buildable. These are not that pigmented, but they are so easy to build up, and I really like that. I also do like super intense blushes, but also for an everyday use, or if I only have a base on and no eye makeup and just want to look a little bit fresh, I like these blushes that you can build up. And Nabla's single blushes are amazing. I would love if Nabla would release blush palette. I would love that so much, but I can really recommend Nabla's, and they are pretty cheap as well. I think Nabla is an affordable brand, at least for us that live in Europe for once. So, not bitter at all. Then two other blushes. I'm going to mention four more, so six blushes. Maybe that was a bit a lot. One of my, I think this is my all-time favorite blush ever. It's Down Boy from The Balm. This is a shimmer blush. Or I at least think it has some shimmer to it. And this is pretty light. And this is the same as the one from Nabla. This is buildable. It's not that intense in the beginning, but you build it up and it's so nice. This is one of my most used blushes, even though I haven't hit pan because I have a lot of makeup. But I really love this. I think that The Balm are so good with blushes and also with highlighters, but their blushes, I just love them. And this Down Boy, it's amazing. The other one is also a shimmer blush, and this is from Milani. This is the baked blush. And a couple of years ago in Sweden, this was the only blush people talked about. I have in the color Bella Bellini, and this has a gold tint to it. and this gives such a nice shimmer. And I don't like the component that much. For some reason it has a little brush here. Like you see, I have never used it. It's like, who the hell uses this kind of brush with a blush? I don't know. But this is really good. This is pretty pigmented, so be a little bit careful because else you get a lot. I really like this. I like to have, when I use this, I like to have maybe a little bit more toned down highlighter because this gives a lot of shimmer, but it's such a nice blush. I really, really, really do love it. And then this is not a blush. I got this from Betty Jean. She uses this eyeshadow as a blush and I tried it. I was blown away and then I said it to Jessica and she really liked it. It's from the Shroud Creepy Cute palette and it is the Strawberry Milk. This looks amazing on lighter skin tones. I don't know how it is with... I can only talk for myself because I only know how it works for me, but this looks amazing and it's so bright, so popping, but it's still buildable and I just like it so much. And you can buy this as a single, so if you want to try it, you don't need to buy the whole palette, even though the palette is amazing. But this Strawberry Milk is such a nice blush and I have thinking about using like more of my eyeshadows as blushes because why not? It should work. And then before we go into the highlighters, I want to talk about the Infinity palette from Linda Hallberg. This is, I don't use this as much for my eyes anymore. I use it mostly for my face. And I love this Pinwheel as a blush. I love this Andromeda as a blush. And I love this Milky Way as a highlighter. As you may see, I have hit pan in this. And this, I really like it. I usually take this with me if I'm going somewhere because I can use some of the shades on my eyes, or I can use all of the shades on my eyes, but I like to use it as an eyeshadow. I use Cigar for my brows and then these as blushes and this one as a highlighter. This is one of my absolutely most used palettes, one of the palettes I really, really love. And I think this, if I ever going to buy a palette again because I ran out of it, I think it's going to be this one. It's just so freaking good. And then I thought we was going to talk about highlighters. And we can start with one that I think a lot of people do love, but I still want to talk about it. And it's the ColourPop Super Shock Chic. And I love the color Lunch Money. It looks like this. I got a dent in it, even though I know that some people like, if you hit pan in a Super Shock, it's not like you ever hit pan because it's like a mousse, so you move it around. But I've used this quite a lot. I think this is a really nice color. It's a little bit warmer, like a champagne. I think undertones and me, we're not friends. But these are actually as good as people say, you just need to find the right brush for it. And then I have two highlighters from Nabla that I love. One that is my absolute favorite highlighter ever. It is Baby Glow from Nabla. And I still haven't hit pan. I think I am pretty close though. And this is just an amazing highlighter. I think I actually could use this without any other makeup. I love this so much. It is just amazing. It works amazing. It looks so good on and it looks so natural. I just love it. And I also really love the Ozone in their Skin Glaze. And this is pretty new to me. I haven't used it that much, but I really, really like it. Don't know what I was going to say, but I really like it. It is as the other one, the Baby Glow. You like need to build it up if you want it intense, but it looks just amazing on. And I think that Noblaq's really good with that when it comes to base products. They are good for like an everyday wear. They are not too much. But if you want it, you can just build it up. And okay, then I have two highlighters left. And the one I'm going to talk about now, it's not especially this color, but this is like my, I think this is my favorite color. And it is the Star Surfer from Kaleidos. It's their pink highlighter. It looks like this. I got all their highlighters in PR and I like them so much. They are a little bit different from what I usually buy, some of them, because some of them are pretty chunky. And these are so nice. If I want something that is really like shimmery and has glitters in it, I take Kaleidos because I know it's going to be a good result and they're easy to work with and they are just, I just love them. And I can't wait until I can try their three new shades. I am so excited. And okay, the last highlighter I want to talk about is a highlighter that I need to use now in June because I haven't used it in a while. And it is the Moon Prism by Lunar Beauty. And this packaging, it's like the prettiest packaging I have. First, when I saw this, I was like, that looks cheap. But then I bought it and it's heavy and it feels really like, I don't know, it's one of the most beautiful highlighters I have packaging wise. I have in the color Mercury, I think, yeah, Mercury. And it looks like this. This is so good. This is so good. Usually I want to have setting spray on to have like my highlighter to sink into my skin a little bit. I don't feel that I need it with this one, so I think it's really good. It is kind of pricey, but it's so good. And I actually started to like Lunar Beauty really much. I have ordered the blush palette. I haven't received it yet. I ordered it from Beauty Bay. I hope it will come next week. And I'm so excited for that because I really like this one. I really like the Moonspell palette and I have the Strawberry Dream as well. I'm going to test it soon. And I think if you want to try something from Lunar Beauty, try the highlighters because they are really good. And that was actually all. These were just some of my absolute favorite highlighters and blushes. And for, it's going to be fun to use like my normal things for a month, but I really like doing these Shop My Stash because I have used some of the products that I had for a long time and haven't like used them before, and then use them, it's like, this is so good. So it has been really fun to do a Shop My Stash, and I will continue in July. And cat hair in my nose, and I thought like I was going to looking so much forward to June when I was going to use whatever I want. But actually, I am looking forward to July to have Shop My Stash again. I haven't decided what I want to do in July. I have no idea. I'm going to think about it in June. And if you have some things you want me to do, please let me know. I have done only Nabla, only creams, the cheapest things I have, the most expensive things I have, and palettes. So I will see what it will be in July. If it is something special you want to see, let me know. I think maybe to do like a different blush every, I don't know how many blushes I have, but I can't use the same blush or the same highlighter more than once in July. Maybe that is a good idea to only use highlighter and a blush one time. I will think about that. Would that be fun? I don't know. But yeah, I really hope you liked this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do so you don't miss any of my videos, and I hope I'll see you in the next one. Bye!